The Ethics of Cyberphysical Systems is the title of a scientific foresight study which has been conducted for the STOA panel of the European Parliament. STOA stands for Science and Technology Options Assessment. What are cyberphysical systems? Cyberphysical systems are technical systems in which network computers and robots interact with the physical world. By 2050, these systems may interact in many domains, driving on our roads, moving alongside us in our daily lives, and working within our industries. Due to the scope of this interaction, understanding the impacts of these systems is essential. Expected benefits and core promises. There are many promises made by integrating CPS into society, including increasing efficiency and sustainability of many of our current practices and creating new markets and growth. These promises include automated cars that enhance traffic flow, reduce pollution and allow drivers to work or relax while in transit. Mass customization of products that closely match consumers' preferences and reduces waste during production. Telecare alarm systems and CPS treatment tools that help to care for sick and elderly people while enabling them to live with more independence. Smart technological aids for disabled citizens that enables them to become more active members of society. CPS in agriculture that reduces the need for pesticides, prevents food waste and optimizes food production, all the while reducing water and energy footprints. Drones and military robots that defend society while reducing risk for military personnel. Unintended impacts and policy implications. While all these benefits sound great, our past experiences have taught us that technologies never operate exactly as anticipated. There are always unintended effects, some of which are good, some bad, and others that are never truly realized. One such unintended consequence may be that 3D printing changes consumer habits, making production so easily obtained that we start producing more and become less attached to our goods. As a result, maybe we become more inclined to discard goods and thus generate more waste. We need to think ahead and avoid such possible unintended consequences while ensuring that these technologies can benefit everyone. Employment and delegation. As we delegate more tasks to CPS, old jobs will be lost while new ones are created, such as repairing robots and mediating between robots and humans. In these circumstances, will humans leave routine decisions to robots to remain focused on tasks that demand creative thinking and decision-making? If so, will we be able to integrate our knowledge with data from these systems? Is it desirable to delegate meaningful tasks to robots when robots can do these tasks better than humans, such as avoiding energy waste or taking care of our loved ones? If robots perform these tasks, would we lose a certain degree of meaning in our lives? What is the value of satisfaction taken from the altruism of unconditionally helping others? These are effects we need to keep in mind. Safety, responsibility, and liability. Safety should be one of our primary concerns while finding ways for robots and humans to work together without accidents. This is especially important when robots operate in close proximity to humans. These systems are large and complex, intelligent and self-learning. But who should be held responsible when the system fails? Moreover, finding the initial cause and attributing liability will prove very difficult. Who will be in charge in case these systems malfunction? In healthcare, is it the doctor, caregiver, or patient who is responsible for failure? Or is it the developer or producer of the CPS? As factories, energy grids, and transport systems become digital networks, how can we prevent outsiders from hacking and infiltrating these systems for nefarious purposes? Privacy concerns. CPS requires vast amounts of data to operate effectively, and this poses several privacy questions. For instance, in order to have optimal energy usage, smart home systems might want to keep track of the times residents are away, which is also valuable information for burglars. Or will robots be spying on the working habits of their human co-workers, maybe even manipulating them to work harder? Should the code of conduct on medical professional secrecy be reviewed, considering the health data stored on connected parts of medico-technical systems, data which third parties can also access? Collecting data on a person's lifestyle and physical parameters can definitely improve their health. But as we proceed, should we discuss how to prevent others from taking advantage of the data shared on medico-technical systems? Social relations. CPS will influence our relations with machines and might even lead to controversies. Should robots acquire some form of moral sense if they are to interact with us within our comfort zone? But as we humanize the robot, how will this affect our self-understanding? And what if a patient gets emotionally or even sexually involved with their care bot? Should this be allowed or discouraged? Also, with CPS, we can build smart prostheses for the disabled. At what point will they turn into cyborgs, possibly even exceeding human abilities? And how will we define disabled or able-bodied in the future? Conclusion. Exploring the future effects of CPS shows that it can have considerable impacts on various areas in our personal and professional lives. The deployment of interconnected, autonomous working machines in complicated data environments involves a number of legal areas, such as responsibility, liability, data ownership, and privacy. Designing cyber-physical systems for operation in proximity to humans means that current safety regulations need to be updated to ensure that individuals are not harmed and that the desired benefits surpass the potential unintended consequences.